Do the Valve Knuckles controllers work with the Oculus Rift? This was a frequently asked question on our latest Valve Knuckles video, as you can see here. So I decided to find out if it is possible. The short answer to this is yes, but there is a catch. Getting them to work with the Rift might not be as easy as it sounds, since the Valve Knuckles uses Steam VR and the HTC Vive base stations. However, I figured out how to make this work using a couple of things, which I'll explain in this video. If you are just here to know if it could work, then you already have your answer. However, if you want to know how to make this work, if it works like it should, and if it's worth it, then stay tuned. This is a dive into VR episode where we share our excitement about interesting VR technology and news. Subscribe if you haven't yet to see more of these types of videos. A special shout out goes to Vince and Valve for sending us the equipment needed to make this work. Thank you so much. And now, let's get started. Okay, as you can see, we are in the Knuckles tech demo, Moondust. And I'm wearing the Oculus Rift with the Knuckles controllers. As you can see, all the finger gestures work like intended. All of them. yeah. It works pretty well. Let's see if we can grab stuff as well. Yes. Yes. Squeeze. Squeezing works. This is absolutely great news, of course, for Oculus Rift users. Oh, and the rocket is just going. But if you want to see truly what the Knuckles is capable of, I recommend watching our previous Knuckles video where we showed off everything that the Knuckles could do. I'm not going to do that in this video, but I will link it in the description down below. Right now I'm just testing it with the Oculus Rift to see if it works like it should. Let's go in here. But how do you make this work? First of all, let me start by saying that these are the Valve Knuckles DV, the dev kit version. This is a version after the EV3 prototypes. Since this is not the consumer version, this guide might change, so be aware of that. This video is just to inform you what is possible, but maybe it won't change and then you'll be able to use this video as a guide to get started with the Knuckles on your Rift once it's released. So, let's talk about the catch. Since the Knuckles work with SteamVR, SteamVR tracking needs to be in place. This means that in order to make this work, you need two HTC Vive base stations, which goes for $134 each. And then you also need something to pair the controllers with. Any HTC Vive headset has the wireless controller dongles inside, so the controllers pair with them out of the box. However, other headsets like the Pimax or Oculus Rift need separate dongles. Fortunately, there is a solution to this. You can get two Steam controller dongles, which you can get for $13 each. However, those do not work straight out of the box with the Knuckles. You will need to update the firmware for it to work. The update itself is free, and I'll show you how to do that later in this video. And then there are a couple of steps on your computer that you need to do to make sure that everything works, like installing the Knuckles drivers and getting Oculus Rift equipment to work with the base stations. So, let's summarize what you need to make this work. The hardware that you need are 2x the HTC Vive base stations, 2x the Steam controller dongles, and of course your Oculus Rift with its touch controllers and its sensors. In this guide I only use 2 sensors, because that's all you need. And the software that you need, Steam plus Steam VR, the Knuckles drivers, OpenVR Space Calibrator. And the good news is that all of this software is free, and I'm linking everything down below as well. Now I'm going to take you with me on what I did to make the Oculus work with the Knuckles. By showing you the setup, I hope to help your decision on whether you think getting the Knuckles is worth it if you own the Oculus Rift. This is probably also the same process if you need the Knuckles to work with other VR headsets that are not the HTC Vive headsets. After the setup, I'll show you more gameplay on the Rift with the Knuckles and whether this works with Oculus Home games. And lastly, I'll let you know if I think it's worth doing this for the Oculus Rift. While you are watching this video, please leave a like if you found this video helpful so far. Let's continue. The first step is to download and install Steam if you haven't yet. I won't explain how to do that, but I'll link Steam down below in our description. The next step is to get your Steam VR setup ready. So you need to connect your base stations. They do not need to be connected to your PC in any way, they simply need to be plugged into an electrical socket. We already have HTC base stations set up, as you might know, and we recommend placing them in opposite corners of your room, placed high up facing down, and they have to be able to see each other. Then one of them needs to be on channel B and one of them on channel C. You do this by pressing the button on the back to cycle through the channels. Once the light at the top of the base stations turn green, you are ready to move on to the next steps. Step number 2. Connect the Oculus Rift and the Oculus sensors to your PC. We only used 2 sensors for this to work. You don't need the third sensor to get 360 tracking with this method. Step number 3. Install Steam VR, start it and finish the tutorial if necessary. Not going to explain how to install Steam VR since it's pretty straightforward, I did link it in the description. If you have started Steam VR and don't see anything working yet, don't worry, that's correct. The base stations will not show up on Steam VR until something is paired, turned on and tracking in your play area. Step number 4. Opt in for the beta of Steam VR, like this. Then install the Knuckles drivers. You can manually install these drivers by downloading them from the tools section of the Steam library. They are called the Steam VR Knuckles driver. Close Steam VR for now. Step number 5. Now we are going to update the Steam controller dongles. We are converting them to Watchman dongles, which is what we need to pair the Knuckles controllers. After you've done this, you can also use the dongle to pair other things like the HTC Vive trackers to get full body tracking on the Rift, for example. Please be aware that I don't know how to convert them back to Steam controller dongles, so if you are using an actual Steam controller with your dongle, you might not want to do this and get an extra dongle for this purpose instead. So to update them, you need the latest Watchman update, which is available in the Steam VR Tracking Hardware Developer Kit or HDK. You can probably get the Watchman dongle update in another way as well, but this is how I did it. So to get it, you will have to apply on Steam as a developer, which is fairly easy to do. I did myself as well with my Steam account. Visit partner.steamgames.com and log in with your Steam account. Click on sign up for the Steam VR tracking license. Read all the text and if you accept, continue by entering your information until you reach the page confirming that you are a Steam VR tracking licensee. Now you can open Steam again and select a library, software, and now you can install the Steam VR tracking HDK. Make sure you do that. Step number 6. Now you can find the Watchman dongle firmware in your Steam folder under Steam apps, common, Steam VR tracking HDK, firmware, dongle, and then find watchmandongle.bin. Plug in one Steam controller dongle that you want to update. Open command prompt and use this command. This depends on where your Steam is installed. Mine is installed in my C drive. If yours is as well, then your paths will most likely be the same as mine, and you'll be able to copy this command exactly. I've also put it down below in the description. Just make sure you use the Lighthouse Watchman update.x and the Watchman dongle.bin files from the HDK folders. If you see this in the command prompt, then it means it worked. Do this for both Steam controller dongles. Step number 7. Now if you start Steam VR, you won't notice that anything has changed. This is because we now need to change some settings in Steam VR to allow the 5 base stations to work alongside with the Oculus Rift. This is turned off by default. To do this, open Steam VR's local directory. Locate the following configuration file and open it with a text editor. The file is called default.vrsettings. I use Notepad++ to edit it, but you can also use your regular Notepad. Press Ctrl plus F on your keyboard and search for the require HMD key under Steam VR. Set the value of this key to false. Now search for the activate multiple drivers key under SteamVR and set the value of this key to true. In the description, I linked a VR settings files that I am using here, so it is tested as functional. Save this default VR settings file and close. If SteamVR is running, close and restart it. When SteamVR restarts, you will see that it is now possible to connect a tracker or controller without the HMD. Step number 8. Plug one of the Steam controller dongles in. Now right-click SteamVR, pair controller. Now pair the Knuckles controller's burr instruction. Do this with both Knuckles controllers. Now connect your Oculus Rift, restart SteamVR, turn on your Knuckles controllers with the Steam controller dongles plugged in, and you will now see that they are paired and showing up on the SteamVR window, including the base stations. They all work together now. Step number 9. You will, however, see that your Oculus Guardian system and the SteamVR Chaperone system do not get along very well. So you will need to calibrate this to make it work. The good news is that this is also the last step before you can get playing. You can calibrate the Guardian system using the free tool OpenVR Space Calibrator. Download and install OpenVR Space Calibrator with SteamVR closed. Link down below, of course. Once installed, you can turn on SteamVR again and you will be able to open Space Cal from within the SteamVR overlay. Don't turn on the Knuckles yet here. Open Space Cal first and click Copy Chaperone Bounce to Profile with your Oculus Touch controller. Now turn on the first Knuckles controller that you want to calibrate. It will show up in a completely different place than you would expect at this moment. Don't worry, this is correct. Open Space Cal within the SteamVR overlay and select the Oculus Touch controller that you are using and the Knuckles controller. Start the calibration by clicking this button while holding both selected devices in one hand and move it around like an 8. The Knuckles controller should snap into the correct place when the calibration is finished, and the calibration will be automatically saved, so you only have to do this once. The calibration will be applied to the other ones automatically. So just turn on your other Knuckles controller and you are ready to go. Once you've got everything set up, it will work as you can see here. Totally in love with the song, so let's do this one. I'm playing Beat Saber here, and I actually really enjoy playing Beat Saber with the Knuckles controllers. I said it before, but I think it just feels right. Plus, the fact that you can let go of the controller without any trouble is just great. It makes you feel more relaxed holding the controllers, and the menu button is positioned just that far enough away to not make me mistakenly hit it. Beat Saber players will know. So I also wanted to test out whether the Knuckles controllers work with Oculus exclusive games. So I tried using Revive to play Robo Recall, Knuckles Legacy Defaults plus Thumbstick for Touchpad. Let's try it out as a default. Okay, so actually the grips, when I squeeze it, it presses the grips. When I squeeze it super softly, it already presses it. Okay, so the buttons are the same too. Thumbstick works. Touchpad is mapped a little bit differently. Like, I'm touching the touchpad on the Knuckles now, and it's using the grip buttons of the Oculus. It's nice that I can see it though. It's very nice. I think we're actually able to play this. Okay. Thank you.
Every time you draw a pistol, Robo Ready Supply Team receives a requisition request.
And it turns out Revive has some bindings for the Knuckles controllers too. This means that you can play any Oculus games with the Knuckles as long as it is supported with Revive. If this isn't, you can try and rebind the keys yourself using SteamVR's built-in controller configurator. Of course, this doesn't bring the separate finger animations that you saw during the Knuckles demo, since developers of a game need to add that to their game themselves as a feature. However, I am pleased to see that I can use the Knuckles with the Rift with any Knuckles-supported VR games. Right now, as said in the previous video, there aren't many games out yet that support Knuckles completely, but I have no doubt that most developers will add support for the Knuckles once it is released for consumers. I don't think Oculus exclusive games will add this support though in the future. So do I think it will be worth it to pay about $300 more to play with the Knuckles on the Rift without even counting the price that the Knuckles will cost? I don't think it will be worth it if you do not have the 5 base stations yet and if you don't have more reasons to get the 5 base stations. It might be worth it to think about this if you are looking to get the HTC 5 trackers for good full body tracking, for example. Since you will need the same hardware if you want to use the 5 trackers with the Rift. The setup is the same too, and once you've done it, you can use the Steam controller dongles for both purposes. I also think it will only be worth it if you plan on playing a lot of VR games on Steam too, since I think the Knuckles will work the best with Steam VR games and maybe not so much with Oculus exclusives. So if you have multiple reasons to get the 5 base stations, then it might be worth it to think about this option. It might also be worth it if you already have the 5 base stations. Because then only for the price of the Steam controller dongles of $13 each and the still to be announced price of the Knuckles, you get yourself a beautifully designed controller for VR. So, what did you all think of the Knuckles with the Oculus Rift? If it were you, would you get the Knuckles for your Oculus Rift even though you have to buy the HTC 5 base stations separately, so you would have to pay more money or put more money in just to play with the Knuckles? Would you do it or not? Let us know the reasons why down below, because we are always curious to hear your thoughts as well. This is also the end of this video. Thank you all for watching, because that is the biggest support that you can give us. A special shout out goes to Ardamin, our right hand patron. Thank you so much for your support, and a special shout out goes to his Patreon page as well. And as always, VR on! This is a dive into VR's. This is also the end of this video, so thank you so much for watching.